Monsanto is causing an atrocity against our sacred corn and our sacred salmon. And as a mother and a grandmother, I will not sit back and let Monsanto kill our next generation. Our people of this land have been genocided by the United States. And so, like I said, no more genocide by these rich corporations. I also wanted everyone to be aware that we have some power group people here today who may, we're trying to keep this mark peaceful, so if anything comes down, don't engage. We're here for a peaceful march today. And we have, this is the first time that Indigenous people, Native Americans, are going to lead the march. We have a lot of female energy here. We have some Native American women here who are chiefs of nations. We have, and they're going to be speaking at a crowded park on issues that is affecting the Indigenous people of this land. So I ask all of you to be respectful and don't engage, and we're going to have a good day today at this march. So we're going to get out there and we're going to shut down Monsanto. We'll have an opportunity for everyone to participate in the open mic at the Aquatic Park. We're going to march down from here shortly down to Aquatic Park, 10 blocks down on the slow march. Luta is going to do the opening prayer, and then we have some Aztec dancers who are going to march with us too. So all the Indigenous people are going to line up first. We can all line up after that. If you have any questions, come to me because I'm one of the organizers. And again, I thank you all for coming here on this beautiful day.
Well, 88% of scientists are in unison and agree that GMOs are safe. The World Health Organization this week has stated that there are no safety issues with GMOs. And when you look at it in terms of 88% of scientists, that puts you in league with scientists who agree that climate change is real. So you kind of have to look to science and say, well, what am I going to trust and what am I not going to trust? And ultimately, 88% is pretty much as close to a consensus as you're going to get in the scientific community. So in the meantime, GMOs are safe. We need them to battle against things like starvation, vitamin A deficiency, and things like climate change itself. We need a crops to be drought resistant and in order to feed the people so there's not famine. So, you know, that's where we're coming from. We think that the other side we respect their emotions and we respect their passion, but we just think they're just wrong when it comes to the science.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Thank you. It's not food, it's meat and seed.
It's not food, it's meat and seed.
Organic love is what we...
Checking our overuse of pesticides. Corporate greed. been watching us all this way, and our call out for them to be sign waving at the same time. This is a worldwide event that Monsanto has already been kicked out of 14 other countries.
Right? But mega anything. California is a climate. California, all the way down to South America, and all the way up to the Arctic. This is one of the few flyways that happens in the United States. These birds fly over these solar panel farms and ignite on fire. It is so hot that they hire people to work in the solar fields, and they're called streamer picker-uppers. They go out and pick up the dead birds. That they call them streamers because they just burn. That's what happens whenever we do mega stuff. So what we need to do is advocate for individual off-the-grid communities. You know, we're talking about organic farming, organic farmers market. Let's talk about organic communities, organic off-the-grid communities that can survive with the conveniences that everybody is used to having. The technology is here. It's already here. So we're so dumbed down to think only those three pipelines is our lifeline. You know, the water line, the sewer line, and the electric line that goes to our house that we must have. But beyond that, you know, we have to wisen up. We can't let them dumb us down anymore. The chemtrails help do that, right? We're alive. Chemtrails are helping to do that. Fluoride in our water. Whose idea was that? That's so stupid. Now we have water bottling companies on the mountain that we're fighting. I talked to the president of the water bottling company out of Washington, D.C., who were wanting to do this. And I said, what do you do to the water? When you get pristine water from Mount Shasta out of a lava tube that everybody drinks right out of the source. And they said, well, the first thing we do is we disinfect it. We put something into it to disinfect it. But why would you disinfect pristine water? Why would you? Because that's our process. And then they add something else to that bottled water so that it tastes the same no matter where in the world you buy it. If you're in Canada, or if you're in Poland, or if you're in Germany, or if you're in Peru, you can buy that water and it all tastes the same. Have you noticed? I noticed because our water tastes different than this water down here. Our water tastes different than the Sacramento area of water. Our water tastes different than Oroville's water. Know what water tastes like, then you have those taste buds, right? Or a lot of people couldn't tell the difference between Coke and Pepsi, right? But an avid drinker of Pepsi will know that is not the Pepsi. If you're not, then you know it all tastes kind of the same. But that's the bottom line of protecting, because GMO brings all kinds of pesticides. It brings all of the seeds that are a major problem with our birds. These GMO seeds get into the bird systems and create weak shells. They're not able to hatch their babies because they can't build the kind of shell that they need because of these pesticides. It gets into our fish. It gets into, you know, everything that you can think of. Whatever eats that bird now has that in them. Whatever eats that fish. You know, even out here in the bay, you know, those fishermen who are getting these fish, there's a problem. And there's no signage, right? And you need signage in several languages. Because there are people who provide their household meals by fishing in this Delta area. And they should have that warning. So, as chief of the Winnemem Wintu tribe and an advocate for healthy living and water around the world, and a speaker for my mountain and the mountains that are with us. You know, we stand for the Mauna Kea against the PMC because it's a water source. Not because we don't like science and then looking at the stars, but the water source of Mauna Kea is critical to the environment. And so we have to all kind of wisen up and do as much as we can for the future generation, like my grandson. Most of us are beyond that time that it's going to actually affect us. But it's our grandkids and the ones out there, the people behind us that are all being hatched all around right now. So it's for them, and it's for those new kids. It's for them. It's for all the people. And like I say, you know, we weren't the first ones to world. We were the last ones. And being the last ones, we have a very small job to help the world go round.
So much could be said about this amazing woman. I like to make fun of her. I call her the grandmother of Fuji. She's over there. You know, but you can find her almost anywhere in her territory, in the East Bay, helping to remind people of her ancestral history, helping to ensure that our ancestors that are being removed or developed are being taken care of. She's always in the community ensuring that our families are getting the best care for our health, getting the best attention for our issues as Indigenous people here in the Bay Area. So it is my honor to introduce to you this afternoon my Uhi, my spiritual auntie, and somebody I look up to as a mentor, Karina Gold. Thank you, Luca. It's my great honor and blessing to be here on our ancestral territory. I want to thank Deborah for pulling this all together. Thank you for organizing this. Thank you for everyone coming out and giving time. And I think that one of the things that I do want to say is this is the Ramatush people's land. And I'm always cognizant that when we are on other people's land, that we are. A lot of people throw us together as Ohlone people under a whole listing of things, but actually my ancestral territory goes from Vallejo down to the middle of San Jose and out to Highway 5. And so we have a large group. You want to come stand next to me? And actually, I'm glad that this woman's standing here right now with me because we are teaming up in September. We'd like for all of you guys to come and join us. We are doing a walk, run, bicycle, boat, horseback ride from our territory in the Delta all the way up to Kaylin's territory in the mountains in September. It's going to be 5 weeks of people doing all of this thing to bring our sacred salmon home. The salmon that runs from Kaylin's rivers down to our Delta and out through the bay comes back through our territory and back up to Kaylin's territory. And we want to bring these sacred salmon home. And that's going to take all of us. And when we're talking about no GMO, no frankenfish, we're talking about bringing these ancestors back to where they're supposed to be. And that's going to take all of us. It's not going to just be the native people that are involved, but all people that live on this world that have to deal with these issues for our children and our grandchildren, that you partner with us to do this journey for these salmon, for your future, for the future of all of us in this world. And so it's for the future of the water. It's for the future of the salmon. It's for the future of the plant life that lives next to it. It's for all of these things to take the poisons out of the water so we have pure water again. To take all of this, to take all of these things that we need, that are necessary, and to give honor to the water and to the fish, to the salmon that need to come back up. So really, it's going to take all of us to do this journey. And I want to invite you to come and do that. We're going to start in September. We'll have it blasted out on Facebook page, and you can see it on either Kaylin or I, both private and public. Deborah's will be blasting it out too. We're all pretty public about our Facebook pages. So please think about that. Think about journeying with us a mile, a half a mile, bringing food or bringing fresh water that's not in bottles, participating in transportation. And if nothing else, giving some of that cash away so that you get that people can do the journey, right? So some of us are here, some of us that are in this area that you know of can also participate. So spread the word is also a good way of doing that. Get on your way. Kaylin has a very busy woman and she has someplace else to do. So we really wanted to make sure you're here and we all know that we have participants. It is time for us to stop the warmongering. It is time for us to stop working with people in governments that are part of the corporate greed. They're taking money from them. We have to make sure that those people that are in government aren't taking any money from corporations. Or we need to make sure that we create a different kind of government. And if that revolution. That's right. And it's okay to say that word right now, right? Because there's people all over the world that don't want Monsanto. There's people all over the world that don't want GMOs. And people
And if they're saying no, they're not saying no loud enough. We outnumber, as human beings, all of those people that are in charge of those governments. We, as human beings, have the right to say no to GMO. We have the right to say no to Monsanto. We have the right to say we want clean water. We have the right to good education. But we have the right to run our own governments and our own lives without having Monsanto in our backyards. So we need to remember that. And so when we walk today, we remember that. So hell no GMO.
Hell no GMO.
Hell no Monsanto.
Hell no Monsanto.
That's it. That's great. Thank you so much for having me here. Thank you for being here.